Defense mechanisms, are they good or bad? Grow your capacity and discover how your defense mechanisms work, how we use them, and how it impacts us with Lifa and Ziggy.
We are back again with another defense mechanism in our series of defense mechanisms.
You make it sound like a rap, man.
No, I'm just excited for each episode.
Yeah,
you're going to add flavor to every episode, I suppose.
Yeah. So this one is the rap thing.
So this is the rap flavor.
There you go.
From the beat afterwards. Reaction formation.
There you go.
They even rhyme, but yeah. that is what we're covering today.
Okay.
Reaction formation.
So what is it?
So reaction formation is where you have either like a negative, or not even negative, but you react to a situation, and whatever you're feeling, you do the complete opposite.
You do the opposite,
do the
from
opposite
what you're feeling.
From what you're feeling. So an example of this is that instead of being angry, or you become helpful in a situation,
Oh, wow.
Or in those ideologies. Or I believe that an example that I read on the internet was interesting is a dutiful daughter who does everything for her mother, you know, take care of her and so forth, but secretly hates her.
Mm.
And I was like, so that would be an example of reaction formation.
Sounds a lot like what I call a slave relationship. In the Emotional Debt book that I wrote,
yes.
There's one section where I spoke about how it happens that when we feel like we have done someone some wrong, and even if that person said, hey, it's okay, we leave it behind us, we don't write off our own debt. And then we fall into what I call a slave relationship. And in a slave relationship, you can't love the person, you only have duty towards them. There's a time where you start rebelling, but that could be stretched out and maybe never happen or happen very late. Mm-hmm. Or you could distance yourself, you could run away. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But that example that you gave, it
yes.
could be someone that is in that first phase where you can't love that person, but you have a duty towards that person.
Mm-hmm.
So you feel like, I shouldn't be angry at my mother. She's not so fragile and whatever,
mm-hmm.
although she's done all these things to me. So you haven't really written off her debt towards you,
mm-hmm.
but you also haven't written off your own debt towards her for what you might have done in the past. And therefore, you have these anger feelings, this feeling I don't want to be with you towards that person, but you feel indebted
to them. So therefore you have to and it follows nicely with the emotional debt. The debt.
Yeah.
I suppose. So
yeah.
you could say that this could be people who probably react, you know, in acceptable ways to a situation, but then they don't necessarily deal with it and that could cause problems. For instance, they have every right to be angry, but they decide not to be. They're like calm. Or not even calm, they're like, they pretend to be happy, like nothing happened, flowers and sunshine.
Yeah.
And I think that could be problematic because then you never deal with the issue.
Yes, exactly.
Yes.
That is the challenge. You never deal with the issue.
Mm-hmm.
And because you never deal with the issue, you can never rebuild the relationship or
mm-hmm.
set up the boundaries that you should be setting up for your own sanity.
Oh, definitely so.
Yeah.
And I don't know, like, I feel like if we could link this to actually your communication module that you have, that you teach in your emotional intelligence, the OB4.
The OB4, yeah,
yes.
The OB4 definitely kind of leads to that.
I think, especially with that part where you have to tell the how you feel
yeah.
and so forth. So when you don't show the proper emotions, if you don't show the anger, the individual will think, it's fine.
Yeah.
Like, you know, there's nothing wrong with what they did.
Yeah, and that's the challenge. We think other people should know what's happening within us. Yeah?
Yes.
You should know that you hurt me. But the reality is people don't.
Okay.
People are very self-absorbed. People are extremely... people are very much in love with themselves these days, even more than it's healthy.
Mm.
Although I don't think self-love is bad,
yes.
I just think the way we've increased it in our society just causes so much chaos.
Mm.
We think people would know, but they don't. We don't even know. I mean, think about it. Have you never done anything to a loved one and not realized what impact it has?
Definitely.
On the loved one, we all have done that.
Yeah.
If we're honest. And other people do that too.
True.
Yeah.
So therefore, it's vice versa. It's something that we have to be aware of is that we can't necessarily address a situation if we don't treat it as it is.
Mm.
With reaction formation, we we feel duty bound, so we never address the situation at the bar. Exactly. Like there's that, we create a slave relationship, and also at the same time, the other individual doesn't know they're doing anything, they did anything wrong.
Exactly.
Because they're so self-absorbed as you.
Yeah. And,
yeah.
And then it just escalates because you see them not acknowledging your
pain
right. And you feel even more grudging and more anger and inside of yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And the worse it becomes in here, the more you think they should know.
It's definitely like,
and it just escalates.
And when it escalates, and then it probably turns out like one of the other defense mechanisms, you displace it or you just, you know, act out and so forth. So, wow, generally, that is good insight for this, because I believe a lot of people might suffer from this, where they think they're doing the right thing by not showing their proper emotions or something.
Yeah.
Whilst
yeah.
they're making it worse. Or
yeah.
for themselves and the other person.
Yeah, their emotions have just become like a cat in a box. They're just scratching the whole time, waiting to explode.
Ah, this is a concept from your book, Emotional
Yeah, yeah.
Also.
Also
look at that.
All yeah, yeah, yeah.
All right, no, this was an insightful conversation that we had.
I look forward to the next one.
Yes, the next one. The next one. Do you know what we're doing next time?
Is it compartmentalization?
That word. I always struggle to say it. Definitely. Compartmentalization.
Yeah.
I really have to think about it.
Things in compartments.
Yes, definitely so. All right.
Look forward to that.
I look forward to this episode of The Word I Cannot Say.
There you go.